Hi, my name is Dr. Tran. Today we'll be talking about tongue tie and tethered oral tissues. I'll just refer to tethered oral tissues for right now as just tongue tie. But when we evaluate everything, it will include evaluating the whole mouth and not just the tongue. So when we talk about tongue tie, a lot of this information may seem new and unheard of for you. And that's a very common sentiment. And a lot of medical professionals are not very well trained in tongue tie as well. So don't be afraid if all this is new to you. Now, when we talk about tongue tie, and we talk about tongue restriction or limitation of motion of the tongue, the main limitation in restriction of mobility is elevation. So really more so that the tongue can't elevate to the roof of the mouth. It's not so much protrusion or if you can stick out your tongue, it's more if it can go up to the roof of your palate. Tongue tie can present with a lot of different symptoms. In babies, it can present most commonly with a shallow latch or painful nursing, difficulty with feeding, poor weight gain, a lot of gassiness or fussiness, clicking with eating. That's because a lot of the air that's being swallowed, either has to present either as reflux or as gas. Dribbling of milk from the mouth, inability to keep the milk in during swallow. And some of those things can be associated with lip tie as well. Now, that's in regards to babies, but even children and adults can have issues with tongue tie as well. Specifically, speech issues, trouble with speech, certain sounds, even difficulty with just understanding the words coming out of their mouth. Fatigue with speaking, so even if you can speak well, if you have vocal fatigue or it takes a lot of effort to speak. And then in adults, the most common symptoms involve neck pain, neck strain, and grinding, clenching of the jaws. For infant tongue tie release, it's called a phrenectomy, which is you're removing the tissue that's connecting the tongue from the floor of the mouth. In general, what we'll do is we'll put some numbing medication underneath the lip or underneath the tongue, and it's just a topical numbing gel. The baby will be away from you for about 5 minutes. And then afterwards, we'll bring baby back and you can do a feeding trial with baby and see if you notice any improvement. And then I will show you the wound and then also show you how to do the stretches so that you're comfortable before we send you on your way. For adult tongue tie releases, I perform what's called a functional frenuloplasty. The procedure itself is done in the office with local anesthesia. I do this with a laser. Go based on what your specific anatomy dictates as far as how much of a release that you can get depends on the amount of restriction you have and what kind of restriction it is.